Hello, my friends of Qatari Labs. Welcome to this tutorial. My name is Saul Montoya. Today we are going to do a basic example of contaminant transport modeling with USGS MT3D. That is actually the latest version of MT3D-MS. Okay, so what are we going to do? We are going to do a model, a new model. Okay, now description is not necessary. We are going to work with just one aquifer. And the top of the aquifer will be 5 meters because we want to represent a interaction with sea, but or not with sea, with a lake or something like that. Okay, and the aquifer will be -5, so from 5 to -5. Okay, we are going to work with, yeah, when you work with contaminant transport, the discretization has to be like really small. Let's say 2 meters. So that's why we are working with 40 and 40, 40 and 40. 5 meters, 5 meters. Yeah, because no, I think that no. It will be okay. Okay. Yep. Finish. Okay, so we have here our model. Okay. Something that I can show you is that in ModFlow and MT3DMS, no, and ModelMuse, like you can rotate the grid, okay? Yeah, you can rotate the grid. In this case, yeah, let's rotate the grid because, like, I want to show that the grid can be rotated and that the plume can be in certain conditions, okay? Okay, now we are going to work with our. Now we are going to work with the topography. Okay, so first of all, let's do. We are going to work in ModFlow 2005. Then what we are going to work is the PCG and boundary conditions. We are going to apply constant general head boundaries. And then we're going to apply a well, and I think that this because there is no recharge on the system, or and then I'm going to apply this will be sealing. No, this is was something because I'm going to use MT3D, but the like silane, less sulfates, yeah. But silane is of light, and there is another discussion on this. Okay, by the way, I know that it might be some people that are watching these videos. This is my email. If you want to talk about any conversation about how you can learn how. Which is the best tutorial for this or for that? Or like if you want to develop some specific, yeah, you can write to me, yeah, because I also want to know which is your opinion about our videos, okay? So we create advection, dispersion and sink and source, okay? And then we are working with MT3D USGS. Okay, and then we check if MT3D USGS is there. Okay, great. So here we have our. Okay, so we are going to create some contour lines. Okay, those contour lines will be like there will be the topography. So these will be. Like this will be elevation 10 meters, formula 0. Okay, and here model top will be 10, and this is by interpolation. Okay, yes, and then I create another one. Este es elevation 7.5 meter. This is as well as 0. This is as well here. And then this is model tops 7.5 meter. Okay. Great. And then we are going to create, because there is a river here and there is a pond here. Okay, and those are at 5 meters. Okay. I do that because of the interpolation. Yeah, so here I create, and this will be as well for the, this is for the interpolation and for both the interpolation and the boundary conditions. Okay, so this is elevation 5 meter, this is 0, this is this one by interpolation, model top 5. Okay. Okay, and then here we have a pond. Here we have a pond. Elevation 5.5 meters, just because the pond is higher than the river. And make sure that everybody is by interpolation. So, I mean, let's review this. So here is by interpolation. This one is by interpolation. This one is by interpolation. And this one is by interpolation. Okay? So if everything is by interpolation, just go here, edit datasets, required model top, and then define like fitted surface. Okay, and great. So here you are. So this is the elevation. Yep. Okay, here is 5 and here is 10. I think that is too much. 10 is too much for the purpose of this. So let's see that this will be elevation 8 meters. 8 meters. And this will be 8. And this one will be 6 meters, 6.5 meters. And this is 6.5 meters. Okay, yeah, because I want it milder. Okay. Okay, great. Great. So now we are going to define the GHB, yeah? Okay, which are I think it's still, no, this will be 7, because actually I want to limit the 7. Okay, yeah, it's something because I want to get a better contaminant plume. You will see this. Okay, so here I control C, control V, and then what I create is a copy. Yeah, so I have done, what I've done is this, and say, well, control Z, okay, first, look. Yeah, this one is this one. Ah, no. Sorry, I will delete this. Okay, this one is this one. If I tap control C and then press control V, it appears a new object that it will be object 0, but this object 0 will be GHB of river, yeah, and this will have one formula, and this will be at 5 meters, set value of enclosed cells, This do not define any model top, but this defines the general head boundary. Okay, minus 0, 1, and this is 5 meters, and the conductance here is direct 0.001. Okay, great. Okay, that's great. Okay, so here you have your, and I can change of color as well, because I want a color of boundary conditions. Okay, great. But we have to go to the mode flow time, because we are going to define a steady state. Yep. And then what we are going to define is a transient, yeah, of 4 years. 4 years. 4 years, 2 seconds. 4 years. No, 4 years. 2 years. 2 years, okay. 2 years, okay. 2 years, 2 seconds. Okay, copy to clipboard. Close. No. Years, 2 seconds, 2 years. Okay, this is 2 years, and these 2 years that will be on transient mode, those will be that's a good question. It will be on a steady state. Why? Because it will I assume that the contaminant plume won't change the, because it's a contaminant plume that is not substantial on the flow of the flow regime, yeah, because it's like the regional flow is much higher than the contaminant pool. That's why I assume that due to this contaminant transport, the flow regime won't be affected, or won't be affected much. Okay, I do this just in order to simplify the project, yeah, because on your own project you will have to insert this as a transient mode, and the simulation will take longer, yeah. But for this, if this is just a tutorial, and then that's why I only do this. Okay, and then I just in one, okay, and then the contaminant transport will be from zero to the end, okay? Check again. Okay, save my project. Say basic example of contaminant plume modeling in mod flow with model muse. Okay, here I create a new one that will be model, and here it will be model one. Okay, great. So now I have here, yeah, and now my boundary conditions can go from zero to the end. Control C, Control V. Once again, this will be GHV of pond, and this will be color of boundary conditions. This will be 1, and it will be, the pond is a 5.5. And then here will be GHV of 1 that goes from minus 1 to 0, and the boundary head is 5.5, and the conductance length is direct, and this 0.001. Okay. So here I have the pond, and here I have, this is the pond, and this is the river, okay? And in this location, yeah, I know that this is 7, yeah, and for me, There is a regional flow that the water level is at 6.8 meters. So I just create one. So it is GHB of regional flow, and this will be of color regional flow. This will be 1, and this will be 6.8, and it will be this, and this will be 0 to the end, 6.8, and this will be 0.001. Okay, so here we go. Oh, sorry. Somehow this do not appear. Wait, five. Ah, okay. Set value of intersected cells, yeah. No, set value of enclosed cells. Yeah, there is a problem with the interpolation. Okay, what is the problem with the interpolation? That this elevation of 5 meters, yeah, it has set value of enclosed cells as well. Yeah, otherwise, I mean, it goes to the interpolation and it goes to the enclosed cells. Otherwise, yeah, and this is the problem, and this is well, this is a well of enclosed cells. Why? Because the elevation can be, I mean, if it's by interpolation, the elevation can be less than 5, and if it's less than 5 and the boundary condition that you are inserting say that this is at 5, it won't apply. So here the river, okay, here the river. Something happens here. I don't know why if I take the interception. Okay, yeah. Okay, it's all right. Okay, so here we have, okay, the regional flows, and these are the discharge. This is the inflow. These are the discharge areas. So, and then, so let's run it. Okay, on layer type, we will put it as convertible. Okay, great. And then, okay, and then we can import the FHD just to see how our. Okay, it's okay. Yeah. Okay, something that you have to consider is that you haven't, because now we are going to insert more. What we are going to insert, there are more layers, so we have to create something special for this. So we have when required layer definition model top. Okay, and then what else? And then we need to data delete more results. Okay, and then here on package of programs we have defined the well, but we have not applied any well. Okay, so here what we are going to put is a well here. Let's see here. I will. Okay, let me Let me add this battle color grid just to see the flow directions because I want to see a beautiful contaminant plume. Okay, it will be here. So this is a well. The well will be located at it's seepage, yeah, but somehow it has to be located at 6 meters, yeah. Yeah, actually, ModFlow MT3D can allows you to model the contaminant transport in the unsaturated part, but I have to see how it works. Okay. Okay, this is the well. It's at 6 meters. It's a well that on the first stress period, this is direct. It is doing nothing, so pumping rate is zero, and on the second one is injecting 0.0001, so it means that the so is 0.1 liters per second. That is the contaminant, the leaks, the solvent or whatever is the sulfates on the system. Okay, that's great. So okay, so we have our well. So we can run our model again. Data, delete model results, okay. And then we run it again. Okay. Yep. The well is injecting this, but 23 liters per No, 2 liters per second come from the head-dependent bounds, and then they go to the river or to the pond, okay, in the extension. Okay, and then I run this. No, okay, I have already run this, and then I will run the MT3DMS run. And it's running. Okay, it's running and everything is all right. Something has happened. Okay, what has happened is that actually you have defined the well, but you have not defined it as sink and source. So the sink and source, yeah, you have to define it as sink and source. Okay, and this here the sulfates is 200. Okay, and now you can export MT3MS. Okay, and now if we go to the bottom, they say the constant concentration that is the well have given in these 2 years this amount of grams. Okay, from this, everything has gone through the head-dependent bounds. So, I mean, it has gone whether to the pond or to the sea. Okay, and what it is already on storage. Yeah, no, what is on storage as well, no? So have. Actually, I don't know why they do not. Yeah, say this is on storage. This is out of storage. Okay. And this has to be some kind of numerical error or something like that. Because it's, like concentration could not get out of storage if the model is steady. Okay. And then, okay, and this is what went out. Okay, so we can. Okay, so we can show our sulfur concentration and look how it appears. Okay, and look how is the contaminant plume at the end of the 2 years. Okay, Cool, that is great, and I think, okay, this is the first part of the tutorial. If you want to know and to have a basic example, that's the example that you have to follow. Okay, on the coming part of the tutorial, on the next videos of this tutorial, is that we are going to insert more layers to this model, and then we are going to explore how is the, I mean, some there we are going to explore two things. First is the settings of the output, and then how the contaminant plume, how concentrations vary with time, and then like they vary with time, and then how is the representation different when you have multiple layers. Okay, so if you want a basic example, this is, and then it comes on the description of the model, another video with, yeah, with more with this with the control of the output, and then multiple layers. Okay, so far thank you for following us. We are Hatari Labs. What is Hatari Labs? Hatari Labs is a blog dedicated to knowledge sharing in open source software. Okay, we have a lot of tutorial, mostly on Model Muse, yeah, Python, QES, and so on. We have some online courses if you want to follow us in some topics. We have a Facebook account, a Twitter account, and a newsletter. And then if you like this video, you can sign up as well for this YouTube channel. Okay, remember that all the files will be on the description of the video, and please have a great day. See you in coming tutorials. Bye bye bye.